Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're trying to figure out the domain, the range, again, to see whether it's a function or not. So the domain for this one is a little tricky because it seems to start specifically at this point right here. So if I'm going to do the domain down here, I'm going to say that it's starting from the negative 3 and towards the right infinitely. So how do I do that in terms of domain? Well, there's a couple different ways. I can write down my x is greater than and equal to, because that's a closed dot. Okay, there's a difference between a closed dot and an open dot. So in this case, the x is greater than or equal to the negative 3. Okay, you can also do it this way. You can also draw something like a square bracket, and you can put down a negative 3. It means you start at the negative 3. Okay, you start on the left hand side, negative 3, and it's a square bracket because it represents, it also includes the negative 3. And do a little comma right here. But the problem is the graph can extend towards the right infinitely, right? So you just have to do that little infinity sign, okay? And you do an open bracket, okay? A curved bracket, sorry. So this kind of means that it goes on and on and on and on forever. It doesn't stop, okay? So there's two ways to write your domain in this case. There's a, I believe this is called the interval, and that one's called a set. And what about the range? The range is the same thing, but this time you look at the y-axis, right? So if you look at the y-direction, it seems like you're starting at the negative 2, and it goes up infinitely because there's an arrowhead. So I could do my y is going to be greater and equal to a negative 2, or I can also do what I just did here for the set notation. It's going to be starting at the negative 2. Again, it's a square bracket because it includes a negative 2. And again, it goes on infinitely. So I'm going to do a little curve bracket right here, meaning that it doesn't stop. It goes on infinitely to the top. And lastly, you're supposed to determine whether it's a function or not. So again, vertical line test. So I'm going to call it the vertical line test. The vertical line test. The VLT, okay? What does that mean? It means you pick your pen or pencil, hold it vertically, straight up, and then you just have to move it across. Once it starts touching your function, which is your graph, as long as it touches once as it moves across, then it is still a function. Okay? So in this case, it passed my vertical line test, so therefore, it is a function. Okay? Does that make sense? Thanks for watching.